Ironically, just at the time the borax company finished building Death Valley Junction, they found a richer deposit of borax about 150 miles away. So the company up and moved their mining operation. So what to do with all the buildings here at the junction? The company turned to tourism and opened the Amargosa Hotel.
Once we went into the tourist business, a lot of times, holiday times, Easter time, Christmas time, Washington's birthday, any time there was more than a two-day weekend was not quite enough for tourists most of the time. But if we had a few extra days, then those were very busy times. And the hotels would be full. We'd rent our own rooms in our house, too. And that was kind of fun.
I'm sitting right now, of course, in Corkhill Hall. They built this hall to serve as a recreation area. They would show movies here, have church services here, meetings. Basically, it was for the entertainment.
We had various programs in our little theater. Besides the movies, they did different shows and dances, and my school always had the children's programs there, too. So now, these days, there's a woman who has taken over the theater, and I always feel like saying, well, we got to use it before you did. But she's getting quite famous.
It was in the 1930s and early 1940s. The town was really a ghost town until Marta came here in the late 1960s.
Marta Becket began her career as an artist and performer in New York City. Eventually, she created her own shows and took them on tour around the country.
Back in New York, when we were embarking to go on the ninth tour, we went to a friend's house who was a psychometrist, and she was also a musician. So she read our fortunes. Now, this was in 1966. She took my watch and my ring, and she said, she closed her eyes and got very much in a trance. She said, you're going to be leaving New York very soon. You're going to be moving to a very rural area of the country, and there you will do the most satisfying work of your life there. And I thought, oh my God, farming? Am I going to be a farmer? Because rural America, you think of farms. No, it's going to be it starts with the large letter A. There's going to be a pig there and some horses. And my heart sank because I thought New York was the center of the art world and that's where you had to be. So I didn't think anything more about what she said. Years later, when the National Geographic came out and did a story on the Opera House and photographed the mural, I realized that Death Valley Junction was what she was talking about. When I was touring, I had a husband and we were parked in Death Valley working on our income tax. We thought that was appropriate. Some Boy Scouts were parked near us. And they were making a terrible lot of noise. And so my husband reached out the doorway and said, shut up, you guys. You're disturbing the peace. They didn't like that at all. So they punched our tire for the trailer with a big nail and all the air came out. So then we were told the best place to have the tire repaired was up at Death Valley Junction. So we limped up to Death Valley Junction, and while my husband was fixing the tire at the garage, I had time to look around this amazing place and discover Corkle Hall, the empty social hall, which had seen many dances, funerals, fist fights, and the like before its time to close. For 20 years it had been abandoned, and when I looked through the hole in the back door, I fell in love with the place and I realized I was looking at the other half of my life. Amargosa.
My inspiration for the murals was being inspired by the artists Goya and Velázquez. And I wanted to create a world which people could walk into and feel they were walking into the past. I wanted to stay in keeping with the Spanish influence because these buildings architecturally are built Spanish colonial style. I wanted to enhance that, so I did. And I also wanted to create a painted audience that would complement what I did on the stage, because people would sit in here for half an hour looking at the murals, getting in the mood for the performance.